Hello friends, welcome to Get My Job channel. In today's video, we'll look for top 10 questions for cracking electrical engineer's job interview. Topic for today's video is three-phase induction motor. So friends, prepare for the interview for the job of electrical engineer. Let's know the top questions on motors which are asked during the electrical engineer's job interview. To support your interview preparation, I'll be publishing series of the videos on each aspect of electrical. To get such videos firsthand, please subscribe my channel and press the bell icon. So let's see the questions. What is the purpose of surge arrestor provided in ST induction motor? Normally friends, surge arrestors are provided in the terminal box of the ST induction motors. The primary function of the type of MSP motor surge protector is to guard the winding insulation of the device being protected. Station class, metal oxide lightning arresters act to limit the maximum voltage up to the device to a predetermined magnitude. Specially designed surge capacitors connected in parallel with the arresters control the rate of rise of resultant overvoltage. The combination of surge arrestor and surge capacitor serve to the limit turn-to-turn insulation stress impressed on device being protected. What types of bearings are provided for the motor? Typically, induction motors are provided with following types of bearing: sealed ball bearings, angular roller bearings, and sleeve bearings. What is insulated bearing and why is insulation provided for the bearing? Bearings are insulated in two ways. Bearing housing is insulated or the bearing outer cover is insulated. The purpose of insulated bearing for the motors with VFD drives or the alternators is to prevent the flow of circulating current in a closed circuit through bearing and ground if the bearing is not insulated, and consequently prevent the bearing damage. In case the current flows through the bearing can get damaged very fast. What is partial discharge in ST motor? How it is identified? Partial discharge is localized electrical discharge that only partially bridges the insulation between conductor and which may or may not occur adjacent to a conductor. TV detection relies on the voltage pulses that are created on the surrounding metalwork when there is a partial discharge within the insulation. These are detected on the outside surface of the surrounding earth metalwork using capacitive coupling. In general, PD occurs in a system operating at voltages of 3 kV and above. However, it should be noted that in some cases PD also can occur at the lower voltages. And when partial discharge happens, typically you will find the white colored powder on the surface where the partial discharge is occurring. What is typical maintenance turnaround for the motor? Typically in turnaround, following maintenance may be required for a large motor. Cleaning of the cooler for the motor, if the motor is air cooled or water cooled. Removal of rotor and testing of rotor and stator. Cleaning of stator and rotor. Checking of bearing clearances and replacement of bearing if required. Testing of motor health, you must carry out some certain kind of test to determine the health of winding insulation. Replacement of lubrication oil. What is shaft voltage and how it is dealt with? Stray voltages occur on rotating shafts in magnitudes ranging from microvolts to hundreds of volts. The former may be generated from the shaft rotation in Earth's magnetic field or induced from the electromagnetic communication signal induction. The latter can be induced by shaft rotation linking asymmetric magnetism of electrical machinery by residual magnetism present in a shaft or in adjacent stationary members or by induction from switching of power electronics, exciters and or current carrying brushes. Shaft grounding devices minimize shaft voltage and prevent current damage. Shaft grounding stops the energy from causing harm to the vulnerable motor parts. Typically, in case of higher shaft voltages, the circulating current will flow through the bearing and bearings will get damaged. Which interlocks are provided for large induction motors? Typical interlocks provided for large induction motors are for forced oil lubricated motors, low oil pressure, oil flow low. For forced air cooled motors, stopping of air cooling fan and high motor body temperature. For forced water cooled motors, low water flow, high motor body temperature. What is bearing and winding temperature alarm and trips for the HT motor? HT motors are provided with 6 to 12 RTDs in the winding to protect motor winding from overheating. It will give alarm and trip if the winding temperature crosses the set value. Typical settings of the motor winding temperature alarm and trip are winding temperature alarm set at 110 degrees centigrade, winding temperature trip set at 120 degrees centigrade. HT motors are provided with RTDs in the bearing housing to protect the bearing from high temperature. Typical settings for bearing temperature alarm and trip are bearing temperature alarm at 85 degrees centigrade, bearing temperature trip at 90 degrees centigrade. What is motor space heater for HT motor and what is its use? For the medium to large size induction motors, a heater is provided in the motor windings. The space heater keeps the internal temperature of motor above the ambient dew point while the motor is off. The heater helps to prevent condensation from forming inside the motor, which can damage the motor windings, bearings and the electrical connections. What are the typical faults which occur in an induction motor? The main types of external faults experienced by an induction motor are overloading, single phasing, unbalanced supply voltage, lock rotor, phase reversal, ground faults and under or over voltage. What are the storage precautions for the large spare induction motors? The motor should be stored in clean and dry place. Motor space heater should be kept on. Every 6 months, motor winding resistance and insulation resistance values should be checked. Every 6 months, motor shaft to be rotated by 1/4 revolution to avoid sagging of the rotor. Motor body should be kept clean and clear. So friends, I hope this information was useful for you and you will take advantage of it. Please like and subscribe my YouTube channel for more such video. Thank you friends.